God bless the reader and the hearer, the doer of his almighty word, and sanctify his truths in the city of our souls. Would you pray with me? Eternal God, we thank you for allowing us to ride on this, to walk on this Christian journey we call life. Thank you, Lord, for touching us early this morning with your tender finger of mercy. And when we woke, Lord, we still felt the warm blood flowing through our veins. We still felt the articulation of our speech and the activity of our limbs. We still had rooms over our head. There was clothes in the closet and food on the table. And Lord, now while we have the time, we want to say thank you. Thank you, Lord, for bringing us safely through another week. Thank you, Lord, for allowing us to come back into the house of the Lord one more time. Thank you, Lord, for being better to us than we could ever be to ourselves. If we had 1,000 tongues, we couldn't thank you enough for your grace and your mercy. Now, Lord, send your word. Nothing more, nothing else, nothing less. A word, Lord, that would save a sinner. A word, Lord, that would reclaim a backslider. A word, Lord, that would encourage a believer. And when you do, be careful to give you the honor, you the glory. In Jesus' name we pray, and the redeemed of the Lord all said, Amen. I want to talk to us today from the subject, the friend of God. Have you ever heard the phrase, I can count the number of friends on one hand? Anybody ever heard that? There's a contemporary scene called the leader of that group is Israel Houghton. And Israel Houghton and Moody sing a song, I Am a Friend of God. And they sing it with such power. Have y'all heard that? I Am a Friend of God. You think we could try it right now, just sing the opening verse? I am a friend of God.
I am a friend of God.
He called me friend. All right, let's try. I am a friend of God. I am a friend of God. I am a friend of God. He called me friend. Give yourself a hand. Come on. Give yourself a hand. Amen. 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 I know the Bible says make a joyful noise, and sometimes we make an awful noise. But God is still in the forgiving business. Amen. Amen, amen. James 2:23 says, and the scripture was fulfilled, which saith Abraham believed God, and it was imputed into him for righteousness, and he was called the friend of God. Isaiah 41 again, but thou Israel art my servant, Jacob whom I have chosen, the seed of Abraham, my friend. It is almost breathtaking when you can say with all assuredness, with all boldness, I am a friend of God. When we think about friend, my brothers and sisters, friend is one who listens, doesn't judge, and somehow makes everything all right. Blindness from the Charlie Brown Snoopy fame said, a friend understands your tears is much more valuable than a lot of friends who only know your smile. If we broke down the letters of friend, the F for friend means free from all formalities. The R means the right to say anything. The I is the ideal companion, either good or bad. The end is no sorry, no thanks. And the D is for dearest to the dearest one. Now, I pose this statement to you. If you want to find out who a true friend is, just mess up something or go through a challenging time. Then you'll see who sticks around. Somebody ought to say amen. A friend walks in when others walk out. My wife is my best friend. I tell her all the time, wherever I go, And I think about it all the time. When I first met her, when I first met you, I honestly didn't know you were going to be this important to me. She's so important to me, just like the air that I breathe. She's important to me, how I'm able to make it each and every day, that you know we're separate, apart, but we're one in spirit. Thank God for the telephone, thank God for wireless connections. Thank God for technology that we can talk as if we're right in the presence of each other. We look through the prisons of life, looking for one who can be called a friend. You need to look at Abraham, who was called the friend of God and the father of the faithful. In John 15, verses 10 through 15, Jesus teaches on friends. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. Greater love hath no man than this, when a man lay down his life for his friends. You are my friends, if you do so whatsoever I command. You henceforth I call you not servants, for the servant knows not what the Lord doeth, but I've called you friends, for all things that I have heard of my Father I have made known unto you. Look at your neighbor and say, it's good to see you, friend. Our Lord Jesus Christ uses the term friend or friends in the New Testament. He told his disciples that they were no longer slaves or servants, but were his friends. It is a great privilege to be called friend of God. Proverbs 18:24 says, a man that hath friends must show himself friendly. And there is a friend, this is Proverbs, the Old Testament, that sticketh closer than a brother. He's the Lord alluding to Jesus the Christ, Jesus the Lily of the Valley, Jesus our bright morning star, Jesus our food when we're hungry, Jesus our water when we're thirsty. Somebody say Jesus.
Jesus.
Well, that brings us to our focus verse. Brings light to some tremendous principles and challenges in this passage. God's holy word. This talks about the characteristics of Abraham and why he was called the friend of God, father of the faithful. Friendship in this connotation, my brothers and sisters, is speaking of intimacy, more than a close acquaintance, one who is attached to one another by affection. So we must understand there was a reason why Abraham was called the friend of God. Abraham submitted to the direction of God. Thus the song, where he leads me, I follow. I'll go with him, all the way. He submitted to the direction of God. Genesis 12, 1 through 4 says, Abram, before he became Abraham, before the name changed, had to relocate from his place of comfort. He was comfortable where he was. But God has a way of making us uncomfortable. God hasn't made anybody here uncomfortable? Amen. You have to follow. Amen. Where he leads me, I will follow. Abraham had to relocate. And the result of God's promise was because you were obedient, Abraham. That's how you became a friend of God. You were obedient to what I asked you to do. I will make you a great nation, it tells us in that 12th chapter of Genesis. I will make you a great nation. And we are familiar with that particular phrase because of his obedience. He separated from the godless crowd of Sodom and Gomorrah. Oh, yes, all that was going on while he was trying to relocate from where he was. Gomorrah, that sinful place, Sodom, where all kinds of awful things were going on. Amen. And Abraham was in the midst of this godless crowd, but he didn't want to be at the wrong place at the wrong time. Sometimes you can be at the wrong place at the wrong time. You shouldn't have been there in the first place, but he didn't want to be in the wrong place at the wrong time. And because he was a friend of God, he did not want to appear that he was endorsing the ungodliness of Sodom. Abraham was called friend of God because he was willing to separate himself from the ungodliness of Sodom. He did not want to get caught up in all of that mess. It's like folks that have whatever challenges they have in life, and they go somewhere to have the problem fixed, and they come back. And they come back right into the same situation, and then they find themselves, they wind up right back where they started. But Abraham, my brothers and sisters, because he was willing to be separated from the ungodliness of Sodom, he was willing to stand on the full dependency of God's promise to Abraham. Standing on the promise of God, depending that God would never break his promise, standing on the promise that God would never leave or forsake, standing on the promises of Christ, his Savior. He was willing, my brothers and sisters. He was willing to sacrifice what was dearest to him, and that was his son Isaac. And it was a test. How many of you know God will test you? It was a test. A test, a faith that has not been tested. A faith that not has been tested is a faith that cannot be trusted. Whoa. 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 A faith that has not been tested is a faith that can't be trusted. 25 years had passed between the promise of God and the delivering of that promise. Now God says, sacrifice him. Kill him. Sacrifice him. He was literally going to kill his promised son. Abraham was a friend of God. He allowed nothing to shake his faith and confidence in the love of God. God had to stop him. In Hebrews 11, verse 17, it says, by faith, Abraham, when he was tried, offered up Isaac. And he that received the promise offered up his only begotten son. That's how familiar. For God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten son. And here we see in the Old Testament, we see Abraham, the father of many nations, being obedient to God. That's what separates us from God, being disobedient. If we're obedient to God, God will bless us and keep us. Somebody ought to say amen right there.
Amen.
Oh, my brothers and sisters, he had that kind of faith in God that would move mountains. He had that kind of faith that would heal all diseases. He had that kind of faith that will turn your tears of sorrow into smiles of joy. He had the kind of faith that God could get me out of any situation. Anybody here got faith like that? Faith that you can't explain it. It's like that clear and transparent tape. You can't see it, but you know it's there. It's like American Express, better than American Express. Don't leave home without it. Somebody ought to say amen. What a friend we have in Jesus, all our griefs and sins to bear. Oh, what things we often forfeit just because we don't go to God in prayer. My brothers and sisters, I challenge you and tell you to keep praying, keep praying, keep praying. And when you can't pray no more, pray some more. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
And here, my brothers and sisters, is some food for thought. It has been suggested. It is possible to be a child of God and not be a friend of God. It is possible to be saved and not have that intimate relationship with God that would qualify you as his friend. Food for thought. Food for thought. May the Lord bless you and keep you. In Jesus' name, amen.